a public candidate debate. We're going to forum. With us is Frank Costello, a state representative who's running for Congressional District 6. Fred, if you want to say a few words to the audience and to the public that you're going to take on your campaign for 2016.
Thank you. I'll be honored to. I came here to support local candidates. I apologize for my voice. Many of the candidates probably are going to experience the same thing. I care about our communities. I've lived in Volusia County 39 years. I've owned a business 35 years. I'm the local guy with a conservative record. I'm here. I didn't expect to speak. Henry asked me to come up. I'm honored to speak. I didn't come here to speak. I came here to support the Port Orange and Volusia County chair candidates because I believe that the more our voters know about all of our candidates, the better decisions we're going to make. There are three people in my race. You said talk about the campaign.
Well, so Fred, let me ask you this. Why don't you tell the folks in the people you see this on video about the change in the districts from St. Augustine area predominantly to almost exclusively Volusia County in some of the environments?
The new districts include District 6 that I'm running for Congress and includes all of Volusia County, roughly 64% of the total Republican vote. I'm running for the Republican primary. 64% of Volusia, about 20% Flagler, about 8% St. John's, southern maybe 20% of St. John's County, and the northeast corner of Lake County, which is maybe 12%. So it's Volusia Flagler is by far the bulk of the district.
Fred, let's give them a little bit of sense of who's in the race. Scott, the Democratic side. Who are the candidates on the Democratic side?
You got me on that one. I know two of them.
Well,
there's Wayne Taylor and George Pappas.
Pappas is a local candidate.
And they're both good guys, but they're both too liberal for my taste.
Okay.
So let's just leave it at that.
Well, let me just Wayne Taylor is a state representative.
Great guy.
And George Pappas, local
attorney. Long-time friend.
Does anyone know who else, any of the Democrats?
There's a man named McGovern, who's a veteran, and another man named McDonald.
Okay.
McGovern and McDonald.
Okay. And on the Republican side, there's Fred Costello, there's another.
There are three of us on the Republican side. Member of the audience mentioned veteran. There are two of us that are veterans. Ron DeSantis is a veteran. I was a captain in the United States Air Force, Vietnam era veteran. There are two of us that are business owners, Gigi Galloway and Fred Costello. There are two of us that have lived in this district, Gigi Galloway and Fred Costello. There are two of us that want to represent this district, and it's not a stepping stone to another district, Gigi Galloway and Fred Costello. Ron DeSantis, solid conservative record. Fred Costello, solid conservative record. Gigi Galloway, good guy, says he's conservative, right. Doesn't have a record.
Let me ask you this, Fred. I don't even.
It's your show,
right? Yeah, right. You're doing great. Let's be clear about this. In the current district, Ron DeSantis is in the district. But when the districts were redrawn, effective the new election after November, he will be out of the district, or just barely on the district, correct?
He's nowhere close to the district. He lives in Ponte Vedra. He will do what other candidates do. He'll find a place to rent during the campaign and say he's moving here. And if he wins, he might stay while he's here. If he loses, he'll go back to Ponte Vedra.
But there's no requirements of federal law.
No requirement. No requirement. It's the right of anybody in the state to run for any federal district they want. It's the responsibility of the voters to vote for somebody that wants to represent them and not use it as a stepping stone.
Will he get the carpetbagger label?
Well, I don't use that term. I just simply say he has made it clear he only wants to be here 2 years, and then he wants to run for either Senate against Bill Nelson or Attorney General. So he wants to use us as his stepping stone to a higher office.
Well, in the 1 minute we have remaining, to be fair to Ron DeSantis, I think as a congressman, he was supposed to run for the U.S. Senate, and then Marco Rubio changed his mind and pulled him back.
So you're blaming Marco for Ron DeSantis not keeping his word?
I don't know.
Well, Fred Costello promised Tom Leak that I would not back in if Ron DeSantis backed in. I kept my word. Ron DeSantis promised me he would not back in if Marco Rubio changed his mind. Ron DeSantis didn't keep his word.
Well, folks, we have a fired up Fred Costello.
I tell it like it is.
Thank you, Fred. I appreciate your
time. Thank you. I'm ready for the local debate.